Clearly that is going live in a second. Is that working? Let's have a look. Yep, brilliant. That was more of a pain than it should be, I'm not going to lie to you. I'm usually half decent at YouTube, but that's a bit weird. Okay, cool. Play. Cool. So yeah, that's a bit behind. Can you hear anything?
Is that working? Let's have a look.
Pop it in the live chat for me. Yeah, so pop your name in the live chat for me. What I'm going to do is, I've got this. This is where I'll do all my tutorials. I will get better at this. Most of the time what I do is I literally just live stream a video of a whiteboard and just do my maths on that. So if you see my channel, that's what it is. So this is a whole new thing for me. So this is why today's garbage. All right, can you type in your name as what your name is, right? That would be super, super helpful. In that, I don't know who you are, and I need to take a register. Is the thing. Oh, Leah, whichever one of them. I can't even keep up. I mean, like, today is going to be absolutely ugh, because first time I've ever kind of live streamed a screen, which is super, super hard, and I didn't realize how super hard it was. Bear with me a second. Okay, cool. So there was more than one person watching that. So can you make sure you've typed in your name in the chat box? There's some super lag on it as well. It's like 10 seconds behind what I'm saying. Check Teams. So that's just Peter's sent me an email asking me how this works. Okay, cool. Let's get back to watching me. Halil, brilliant, Yasna, Rohan, it's good to see all of you. Okay, first things first, let's lay down some ground rules. Not really about you, because obviously we get along just fine. This is a public arena for YouTube. So use your individual Microsoft Teams chat if you need to say something that you don't want the whole world to know. All right? So like this, the YouTube is for like the teachery bit of tutorial. And Microsoft Teams, your individual chats, the ones I sent up for you for the one-to-ones, that's the place where you're going to find the best kind of like privacy for your kind of whatever issues that you've got, all right? So here, just remember that the whole world can see this by the definition of this being YouTube. So just don't say anything reckless. Don't say anything that'll get you in trouble. Don't say anything that'll get me in trouble and all the rest of it. So I've got six people watching now, and I've got Leia, I've got Halil, I've got Yasna, and I've got Royhan. Can all the other people that are watching, which is at least two and potentially more, if you are watching this, can you type your name in the chat box? I'm not going to start this for about 3 or 4 minutes because I reckon it's going to take a people to figure out a little time how to, you know, get on this and all the rest of it. So I might start maybe 25, 26 and I'll just amuse you with my usual brand of stand-up comedy. It's depressing, isn't it? The PowerPoint I'm showing you has been emailed to you as well as a to-do list. So like all the stuff, if I'm making an absolute hash of this or your Wi-Fi is, you know, struggling or whatever, all well and good. Look at the top something and say, no, I can't do that. That's annoying. I deliberately don't have my login on this tablet. So I'm kind of watching the stream on the tablet and you know, you're streaming my screen as well. Okay, cool. I hope everyone's, you know, kind of cool with this. The Ruthless Noob. Message retracted. Give your name, yeah? Just give your name. Make my life easy, all right? Because if I can't mark you, and I'm not going to, I mean. So you put your proper name. We'll get on with that. 3 or 4 more minutes, then I'm going to start, all right? If you want to get ahead on this, for whatever reason, remember all the resources I sent to you. And we'll have a look for this PowerPoint that we need to be doing. There won't be many like this. I think we go straight into one-to-ones quite soon. And we just did one-to-ones. So I'm not sure what the rationale behind that is. Perhaps they're just going to say, well, let's do all the one-to-ones while we're locked down. And then when we're back in college, we can have actual proper things. I suppose that, now I think about it, that doesn't make sense. Rashida has randomly sent me more maths, which is good. Like Rashida. But that's not relevant to anything. couple more minutes. I'm going to wait before I get started. It seems to be steadily on six. I've got six people. I don't think anyone else has either figured out how to do this or just bunked it. Well, you know what? When the attendance starts racking up, I mean, people will start showing up, I guess. But yeah, give it about another minute. No more than a minute. 25 past we start. No mercy. So if you are here, as I said, please do pop your name in chat box. I don't care about liking or subscribing. You do that if you want. Don't do it if you don't want. I don't care. I'm not doing this for the glory, whatever little glory there is about being a YouTuber these days. I certainly don't get any money out of it. I'd look that up. You need 1,000 subscribers minimum, so I don't get any money out of this. I'm very sad. Okay, let's go. Yeah, let's go. Okay, so planning your progressions. This one's all about what happens next. And, you know, everything's really, really up in the air right now. So having an idea of what's going on in people's lives and, you know, what the situation might be in a few months' time, I think is actually quite handy. So let's see what we've got. So what are the key dates? So from the 4th of May to the 1st of June, you'll have one-to-one. So that's... Do we have another one before that? I hope so. I reckon we're going to have one more tutorial. So yeah, that's fine. I mean, I want to have one more tutorial before we go into one-to-ones. If you're someone who's specially going for apprenticeships or specially going for art and design, can you let me know? Because you can change tutor group for something that's better than that. All right? From the 8th of June, we're going to start working on personal statements for UCAS and for jobs and for apprenticeships. And in September 2020, you need to start doing stuff for UCAS. Now, if you're an Oxford-Cambridge person, hey guys, it's good to see you, those people that just popped on. If you're an Oxford-Cambridge guy, that's all a lot earlier, yeah? And I'll show you that in a minute. But if you're going for medicine, that's all different as well. But for generally, those are your key dates. So next week will be a normal tutorial. One-to-ones will start again from the 4th of May to the 1st of June. And as I said, I think they've done that. So like maybe, God willing, if Miss Rona lets us go, we might be back in college after that. Maybe a couple of weeks just before the end. Just to make, maybe more to see your face more than anything else. Check everything's okay, etc. So that's why they're doing one-to-ones in that section, right? So you've got four paths, right? Well, there's more than four. You can do what you want, can't you? But making UCAS, taking a gap year, straight into work, and apprenticeship. And probably the biggest thing I'll say to you is those are not mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive is a maths phrase. It just means doing one doesn't mean you can't do the next one, right? So if you're making a UCAS application, you should plan to maybe thinking about doing an apprenticeship, maybe thinking about going into work. If you're thinking about a gap year, think about, okay, fair enough, there might be a gap year. I might want to do a gap year. But what happens if, like, Corona flares up again? God forbid, a year and a half down the line, or something else pops up. Do I have a plan B, C, D, right? And you need to start using this time to research. And to be fair, like, I know you've got work, you've got lessons and all the rest of it. But those of you that have got jobs, that's presumably dead now. And it's all the stuff about, you know, travelling into college is no longer a thing. So you do have more time. I know some people are doing their fasting at the moment. Ramadan Mubarak to all of you guys. But it's not the case that, you know, you can... you're probably spending quite a lot of your time, as the song goes, bored in the house and in the house bored, right? Can't believe I quoted that song. But you get what I mean, right? So you've got time and now's the time to do it. Pros and cons of university. Pros and cons of university are probably more than what you've got there, to be fair. Why is that turning yourself off all the time? I don't know why. It's being super annoying on my tablet, so I can't see the chat. Good, thank you. So yeah, pros and cons of university. You've got some time to think. It's a good experience. It's quite a nice life experience, all things considered. There's worse things you can do with your life in 3 years. Obviously, it's expensive, yeah? It's one of those things that, you know, it does... I've heard this from people that didn't go to university. It almost defines quite a lot of you, especially in your early 20s. So maybe 3-4 years after coming out of university, people will still be saying, oh, these are the shared experiences, these are the family. I mean, once you get to your 30s, you don't talk about university anymore, because obviously you've had 10 years in the world of work, and, you know, it's all in the past. But, like, I do know there's people that do say, well, they feel like they missed out. And, you know, some people just won't feel like, well, you know, I saved a load of money, I'm happy that I missed out. And great, and that's all good. But, you know, addition to all the kind of sensible stuff that's on that PowerPoint, that's a true thing. How much you miss out, I mean, it depends what kind of person you are. I know one of my students, one of my favourite students, actually, was talking to her yesterday, and she said, I'm just tired of the school education system. I've had enough. I'm ready to move on to the next thing. And it's like, okay, fair enough. Maybe not for you, then. Apprenticeships and school leaver, you get some money. You might get a degree, actually. Some of them get a degree. If you are interested in apprenticeships, again, it says let me know, so let me know, right? You've got the team chats. You've got the... The thing is, like, I can only see who's on here by... I'm live streaming my own content, which is mad, on a tablet. Because obviously if I look at my stream now, the only thing you'd see is what's on my stream. So you definitely do these two screens. So I'll keep refreshing it once every so often. What I should do is put headphones in so I can hear my own voice as well. But okay, never mind. Doesn't matter. You don't need to know about my life doing YouTube. I'm learning. So yeah, apprenticeships. Yeah, I mean, also like, in terms of apprenticeship, just remember it's not a generic degree. It's a degree that's tailored to what you want. So if you super know you're into finance, an apprenticeship degree is a good shout. It's a good shout. They'll pay for you to do university, some of them. If not, they'll be paying you. There's a good chance there'll be a job at the end of it. Yeah? So that's... You can see why it's appealing. Again, sponsored degrees are very, very similar. I mean, you'll find law firms do fairly few sponsored degrees. So if you show some real skill in something... I remember it was super handy for me because I got... When I did my law conversion, part sponsored by debating, because like they saw me debating at championships. I'm like, okay, cool. He probably would turn out as a half-decent speaker. So that, you know, it's there. I know a few of you are musicians. That's another one, potentially. Especially abroad as well. If, you're kind of open to going, say, to America, that might be a shout. Because they tend to pay fees, even though the fees are humongous, they tend to pay fees for people that will kind of like add to prestige of the university. So you can get a thing like a music scholarship or a debate scholarship. But it's a big jump. Gap year, have some fun. It's more than that. It's much, much more than that. It can be very expensive. There's one other thing as well. You can't waste it. Do you know what I mean? I'm thinking about taking a year out at some point. Maybe next year, maybe year after. Depends what Corona says. Depends what I feel like. And I know for a fact that every single person every job I apply to afterwards is going to pull me up and say, okay, why did you take a year out? And I mean, the real reason is because I'm tired and I've had enough, but I can't really say that. Do you know what I mean? Not had enough of you. I love you guys. But you know, I've been teaching for 12 years. You know, time to move on, right? So like, if you are going to do a gap year, make sure it has some point to it. Make sure there's a kind of theme, an idea behind it. One of my very old friends, he's about the same age as me when he did it. He just basically bought himself a car and said, I'm going to travel around the United Kingdom being a supply teacher because I want to see the whole country. And that sort of makes sense. You know, you took a year out and that you come back, you're refreshed, you're ready to move on in your job. But if it's something like I smoked weed for a year at home, I played my PlayStation, I got really good at FIFA, that's not going to be a one. Unless you're one of these esport guys. I mean, in that case, you can do one. There's your timetables and all the rest of it. What if you don't know what... Thank you. First of all, can I just thank Khalil for being the first person to ask a question, because otherwise this just becomes the Goswami monologue. And to be fair, that's what tutorial usually is, but you know. Right, what if you don't know what you want to do? Bloody hell, that is a very, very deep question, Khalil. That is a super, super deep question. And if you don't mind, I'm going to take a minute to think. I'm going to waffle for a bit. But in my head, I'm thinking about how to answer that. Because honest truth of the matter is, that's a deep, deep question. All right, for those people who do know what they're doing, I will come back to that question in a little, don't worry. Before I like shut this channel, you know, before I close this live stream, I will answer that as best as I can. Choose this sort of subject. So basically, here's your pathway. I mean, you've got the PowerPoint. I don't think you can read, right? The biggest thing I'm going to say to you, and this is really super important because we can't see each other face to face till at least June, is talk to me more. Like, some people got into the one-to-ones. I'm not going to name names. Like, bless you. It was super cool to hear from you. And, like, you need to understand that your tutors and your teachers care about you. And it, like, all well and good. But some people were just like, I'm not going to answer that. And, I mean, we don't know what's going on in your life. So if you start struggling, I'm not saying you need to kind of, like, keep in touch with us to make us feel happy. I have enough friends, don't worry. Yeah? But it's much more the case that if you are struggling at home, if you've got issues, and you say nothing to us, we can't help you. And you'll be amazed by the things we can help you with. I've arranged for students to get some funding for their laptops. They didn't have a laptop and had to share with their family. Fortunately, that's closed down. I didn't get a chance to tell you about it because, you know, it happened over like a two-day period. There'll probably be more funding available if you're struggling for money, if your family's struggling for money, especially around educational stuff. There is so much going on in terms of like online things that universities are doing. Please read Get Ahead News. I mean, I know it's super long and, you know, yawn, but there's so many good things in there, and it's not really yawn at all. I've done a few references for people as well. I mean, Yasna, can you drop a word to me about something you... I don't know if you saw what I wrote for you. I wrote you a reference, but I added something else about it. We need to talk about that one, so just drop me a message on Microsoft Teams at some point, all right? Not now, though, so I'm talking. Here's how UCAS points work. Okay, so, shall I do humble brag time? No, I'm not going to do it. But you can work out, like, from your predicted grades, or at least your progress grades, how many tariff points you've got. Now, predicted grades, I've heard a lot of people ask me about this. There's going to be mechanisms put in place to make sure you get fair predicted grades. There will be no proper full-on mock till September, all right? No mocks till September. You might get individual teacher mocks, but you won't get the one. How can you, you know what I mean? Like the proper mock is you sat in an exam hall doing AS level content. That won't happen till September. It just wouldn't be safe. Now, your teachers might use other ways to assess you. I'm using two things in my class as well as the mock. I'm using portfolio, which people are sending through me through Microsoft Teams, and also a project. I mean, that might also be the case for you. I'm not saying there's not going to be other things that are going to assess you, but like the sit-down exam where the pen and the paper and the clock and whatever won't happen till next year. All right? So let's take an example. Suppose you had a student, suppose you were a student that got 3 A's. Your tariff points would be what? 148 times 3. 50 times 3 is 150, 144. Yeah? You'd be able to walk into any university anywhere, practically, other than Oxford and Cambridge, and you know how that works. Oxford and Cambridge are a whole different kettle of fish. If anyone's interested in that, pop that in the chat, and I'll talk to you about Oxford and Cambridge. Remember, the chat is massively, massively delayed on my screen. So like you might type in a question, I'll probably see it 5 minutes later, and that's why I haven't responded to you. But Halil, that's why it took me so long to respond to you. Right. So that's how they work. And if you've got ASs, they're worth not quite half, a bit less than half. That's changed. It used to be half. It's not half anymore. As I said, use your time to search stuff. Now, I have emailed you a to-do list, all right, for Candy tutorials. Do it. Yeah, do it. I suspect, you know, instead of doing, you know, because you can't really do the 2 weeks work experience, the 20 hours is probably dead as well. So what I think people will look for progression on tutorial will be stuff like, have you done your to-do list on MyCandy, all right? Because all the stuff that, you know, you were supposed to do before Corona, obviously no one could say do 20 hours of enrichment anymore. How could you? I mean, you could watch online videos, I suppose. Okay, so here's some slides. So if you want to do universities, this is the big one. Follow this. Erasmus, I think you need to look up. I don't know if that's still going to, like, post-Brexit, still going to be a thing. So just be aware of that, just in terms of Erasmus. You need to have one university as your backup. So, like, I went Cambridge, Imperial, King's. And King's was my backup. Cambridge I didn't get. Imperial I just didn't like, because they're a bunch of psychopaths. They're probably changing out, but they're horrible people then. So I said, like, tell me that, I'm going to King's, all right? So that's how it would work. My third choice was much, much easier to get into. So Cambridge, as you imagine, was straight A's. Imperial was straight A's as well. The thing is, I didn't get an offer from Cambridge. I got to interview, didn't get further. Imperial, I got the offer with straight A's, but chose not to go to it. And then, like, King's was, like, AAB, I think. So, like, you have one that's a grade down, yeah? So, like, a more... Suppose you're a weaker student. I'm not saying any of you are weak. And you're C grades. You should maybe go... three universities that are all C grades. One university that's aspirational, that's maybe B grades. And then have one that's D grades. I don't know, a London Met or whatever. Always cuss out London Met because I've actually, you know, I've spent some time there. I mean, spent some time there. Never mind, that's a story for another day. Anyway, foundation years. Foundation years are generally offered for two reasons. One of them is if you haven't quite got the grades, or one of them because you haven't quite studied the right subjects. But it's also possible to be used as a kind of a method of social mobility as well. So generally foundation years are like, oh, I didn't quite get the grade. If I do another year to prepare. I'll give you an example. This one boggled my mind, right? Last year, somebody got a U in mathematics A-level, and he's now doing a degree in mathematics after a U in mathematics at A-level through a foundation year. So it's mad. That's mad in my opinion. But there's some good stuff out as well. Like dentistry is one good example. My beloved King's, I'm not just trying to hype up King's because I went there, drops the dentistry requirement a grade. It doesn't offer many places like that, but it does offer some if you do a foundation year. So it's often the case that people will apply for straight dent, which is 5 years, and then dent plus foundation, which is 6 years. So, you know, there's things, it's not just foundation years are bad. The thing is, you have to pay a bit more money. Yeah, you've got to pay a bit more money. So you do another year as well, aren't you? Okay? Now, this is the big one for apprenticeships. Remember, you've got this PowerPoint, so don't think I need to start scribbling down all these words. It's not a thing. That's fine. See, I've dropped... Someone's left me. I mean, that's kind of harsh, but never mind. Life like that. I hate my tablet right now. It's totally messing me up. I'm trying to play this live. I just won't. Okay, cool. I want to see who's still here and who's not. So, cool. That's the apprenticeship slide. Remember, you've got the slide. Click on the stuff. Just follow it through. Let's go back. Now it's time for your question. What do I want to do? So you got yourself a quiz there. I recommend doing the quiz. Do you want to go to university? That's the question. Yeah? I mean, I think from knowing you, you probably do. Looking through different jobs, because sometimes you can maybe a degree apprenticeship is the one, right? Think about it this way. This is a mistake I made when I was younger. Look at the thing you're applying for. Say, do you want to spend 3 years of your life doing it? Because university is fun. It's not all just about, you know, studying. But it is a big part of your life, especially near, like, the summer months. Like, not summer months, early spring. So, like, March, April, May, June. Tells you what kind of student I was. I mean, I just studied in 2 months before the end of the exams. And then passed your exams as well. But it's... If you are unhappy in lectures because you did pick the wrong subject, and I'm speaking to someone who was. I regret doing maths. I don't regret the fact that it's given me a living. I don't regret the fact that I get to teach. I love that. But I should not, fundamentally, someone should have slapped me in the head and gone, don't do a maths degree because you will be unhappy. And I'm trying to kind of say to you, don't be like me. Think to yourself, visualize yourself in that lecture hall. Are you going to be happy for 3 years? And you might think to yourself, Vijay, shut up. I'm poor. I understand that. I'm not saying, do you know what I mean? I need money. I need to do this thing. I've got discipline to work. And I'm going to say, okay, fair enough. I respect your hard work. I respect your discipline. Da, 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 da. It's hard to do well when you're unhappy. All right? You might think that, yeah, I'm tough enough. I know, suppose you say, I want to be an accountant. I hate mathematics. I hate numbers. But I know an accountant's going to pay me well. I'm going to come back and say to you, well, there's two things I'm going to say to that. First of all, yeah, I believe you're tough. I believe you're hardworking. I respect that. But then you're spending 3 years of your life to study something you don't like in order to do a job for the rest of your life, which is something you don't like. You only get one shot on this earth. You know what I mean? Try not to torture yourself too much, right? Money is important. Don't get me wrong. Money is super important. But there's loads of ways of making it, right? Okay, so before September, what are your goals? You should know what the hell you're doing. So Halil, that's you, right? You need to know what you're doing. Have researched what you're doing. I want to do astrophysics. Okay, great. What the hell is astrophysics? What would you need to know? Not, you don't expect you to know the subject. It's like, what sort of things can you get out of it? All right? How are you recording your research, right? A lot of people think research is, I'm going to pull up my tablet, I'm going to Google, I don't know, let's pick a university, Queen Mary, yeah? I'm going to look at their biology. No, biomedical science. What is it? People do biomed, or what is it, yeah? And then you look at it, you read it for a few minutes, go, oh, that's exciting, throw the laptop onto your bed and go off and do whatever you're doing. That's not really research, because what you need to be doing is comparing it against all your other options. Any dude that's doing economics already understands this principle. It's called opportunity cost. If you choose to do biology, you can't do chemistry, for example, yeah? Or maths, or philosophy, or gender studies, right? You're not just saying, am I going to enjoy this degree? You should be thinking, am I going to enjoy this degree or this job or this apprenticeship more than every other job or apprenticeship or degree that's open up to me? It's not just that you're going to enjoy it. It has to be the best option for you. And that's what research is. You need to be comparing. Create your CV. And if you're struggling with your CV, drop me emails. I'm really good at CVs. All right? As you can imagine, because I'm a grown man. I should be good at these things by now. Virtual open days are a big one, because you won't be able to travel so much. Research. I mean, you can see it at the bottom. Research, research, research. Entry requirements are super important. There is a heartbreaking case going on. I can't tell you who it is because it's someone still at this college where they're totally unfit for the course that they want to go for. It's just not going to happen for them, yeah? With the best will in the world, if that person got the course that they wanted, it would be insane. It would literally be, it'd be like winning the lottery and then winning the lottery the next week and then winning the lottery the week after that, right? But because that person hasn't adequately researched the entry requirements, I'm having an absolute, I mean, it's not just me. Because I don't want to be, I'm not the guy who kind of puts water on people's fire to learn and fire to succeed. But it's just, you know, this is impossible. That's like me trying to run in the 100 meters, you know, in the Olympics. You could say, yeah, go on, Vijay, you're good at running. But clearly you're not good at running at my size, but you know what I mean? The point of the matter is there's some things that are just flat out impossible. And you need to know where your thing is. So this is what the situation is then. You need to be researched. You need to know whether the things you're going to do are reasonable, whether the things you're going to be... Leah Matthews just emailed us saying, don't. I'm just going to just respond back to her and just advise her to check Microsoft Teams. Never mind, it's on the end of the world. I'm not going to throw a hissy fit over that. Yeah, so just get use this time productively. Is there anything more I need to talk about? No, that looks like it's it. I am going to do the following. I'm going to end this live stream so you can all go and do whatever you want to do. My Microsoft Teams inbox is always open, yeah? I mean, if you send one at 3 a.m., you'll get one response in the daylight hours, but it's there. Use it, right? So if you are someone who's thinking, I don't really know what to do, I want some advice on this, I'm struggling with that. It's weird, but I've heard more from my maths classes asking for help for things than I have from my tutor group. That might be because you're just like the best tutor group in the whole world that never needs anything. That's great. If you are, it's great, but it doesn't usually work like that. So if you do need anything, just hit me up on there. Take care otherwise. I'll see you again next week. Next week, what we're going to do is I'm going to open up a Microsoft Teams call as well. So you don't just have to listen to my voice for half an hour. I do like the sound of my voice, I've got to say. Bye. Well, not quite bye yet. I need to do this. I need to do that. I do that. Halil, can we talk about economics in the chat? Is that all right? Okay, see you later.